I've identified three areas of knowledge you need to understand at an appropriate level. Not necessarily you as an individual, but you or your team need to have this collective knowledge. They are the science, the instrument, and the organization. So first, the science. That's the science of your product. By product, I don't just mean the formulation. I mean the formulation, its container, or the surfaces that it comes into contact, perhaps during recirculation in a manufacturing operation, or upstream processes, the synthesis or crystallization of the dispersed material, and so on. It's the whole of the product itself, not just the formulation. Primarily, you need to understand the colloid science of your product. You have to know the colloid science to understand the assumptions that you're going to have to make about your sample when you measure it. The second is the instrument. You need to understand how your instrument works. We don't have to understand it in tremendous detail, but you need to understand it at a sufficient level that you know where the assumptions lie. And the third one, which tends to be overlooked, but is often the cause of poor decision making, is your organization. If you don't have the right people with the right skills, you can't make a confident interpretation of your results, and therefore you risk making a poor decision. I'm a colloid scientist. In 24 years working in R&D and the manufacturing organization, 24 years in a multinational company, I met 5 other colloid scientists. And not all of those colloid scientists were able to put their skills to use. What other people or departments might exist that have the knowledge you need, but you simply aren't aware of, even in your immediate part of the company? There's the organizational politics, which sadly are very evident and can negatively impact the ability of you to make a confident decision. These three areas, the science, the instrument, and the organization, interact. And they all bring with them assumptions about your decision making. I gave a talk about this to the American Chemical Society a couple of years ago.